Now, the question number one first. Okay, so the question number one, you can see here. The applied input AC power to half a rectifier is 100 watts. The DC output power obtained is 40 watts. Then what is the rectification efficiency? Then what happens to the remaining 60 watts? That is the question now. So now what we will do now, first thing is we have to find out the rectification efficiency. That is nothing but rectifier efficiency. The first thing is solution. So let us go for the solution. So what is the rectification efficiencies we can call this is eta. That we can call as eta efficiency is the DC output power, that is PDC divided by PAC. I hope you remember this formula already we said, right? Efficiency is nothing but we can define it as what? Eta is equal to PDC by PAC. So now what is PDC? That is nothing but DC output power. What is the DC output power here? The output power they given in terms of how much? It is 40 watts. So 40 divided by what out of PAC? That is nothing but input. The input power is 100 watts. So what will be your efficiency now? It is like a 0.4. That is nothing but I can say it is 40% efficiency. When it means here, the applied input AC power to the half rectifier is 100 watts. And the DC power applied is only 40 watts actually. So the efficiency will be 40%. So this is the answer for the first subdivision. Now we have to give the answer for second subdivision. So what happens to the remaining 60 watts? Now what happened actually? Now here the 40% efficiency after rectification does not mean that the 60% of power is lost in the rectifier circuit. In fact, the diode, your half wave rectifier diode will consume only little power due to its small internal resistance. So the 100 watts AC power contains as 50 watts in 50 positive off cycle and 50 watts in negative off cycle. The 50 watts in the negative off cycle are not supplied at all, but only the 50 watts in the positive off cycles are converted to 40, because as you know that in the off rectifier, during the positive cycle only the diode will work. During the negative off cycle, it won't work. So simple, I can say positive cycle is 50 watts, negative cycle is 50 watts. So the negative 50 watts, it won't work. So that 50 only convert as 40. So now let us see what will be the power efficiency now. So the power efficiency, they can say as nothing but the power efficiency will be like output is 40, correct? Output is 40, input is not 100, it should be 50. Why? Because during the positive cycle only it will work. During the negative cycle, it won't work. See, simple I can say, this will be your input, but the output will be this much. So in this, I can say, this will be your, the positive cycle will be 50 watts. Negative cycle will be 50 watts. So the power efficiency will be what? During the negative off cycle, it won't work. But during positive cycle only, it will work. So that only we have to consider now. So 50 is the input. This is input. Okay. The output is already given in the question. That is 40. So how much the power efficiency now? The power efficiency will be, I'll get as 90%. Okay. 80% is the efficiency we'll get. So if you into 100, you have to multiply that. So although the 100 watts of AC power was supplied, the half-wave rectifier accepted only 50 watts and converted into 40 watts DC power. So therefore, it appropriate to say that the efficiency of the rectification is 40% and not 80%, which is power efficiency. So answer is 40%. Already we written. That is the answer for this question. That is why what happened, the remaining 60 watts is, that is the reason which I said. I hope you understood now what I said, right? So now this will be your first problem. Now let us go for the second problem. Okay, see the second question now. Let us study the second question. An AC supply of 230 volt is applied to a half-wave rectifier circuit through a transformer of turn ratio 10:1. Now we need to find out, one is the output DC voltage, that is VDC. The second one is peak inverse voltage, that is VIC. Now you have to assume the diode is ideal. So now let us what to say. So the diagram is this. See, this is what the diagram achieved. So now here they said the input is 230 volt, right? The AC input 230 volt. Then they said through a transformer turns, that is 10:1. This is what 10:1. See here. 10 is, this is the primary winding. This is called as primary winding. This is called as secondary winding. That has 10:1 now here. So now, so normally the output, the RMS voltage, which will generate based on the turns of the coil, like how many turns, like the primary winding and secondary winding. So based on that only, this RMS voltage will generate, actually, it will get from this. So let me give the solution. Okay, so first, now the primary to secondary turns, or I can say turns ratio. Okay, we'll call this turns ratio. Primary to secondary, that is N1 by N2. I hope you got it now, guys. N1 by N2. N1 by N2 is equal to, what is N1? The N1 is nothing but 10. N2 is 1. So this is, from this I can say this is like a N1 colon N2. You click like this. This is what N1 by N2 is equal to 10 by 1. So this will be 10. Next, RMS primary voltage. Let us find the RMS primary voltage. Let us find the RMS primary voltage. That is nothing but input voltage, right? That is Vin. That is only we can call as RMS primary voltage. That is nothing but 230 volt. That is the RMS voltage we'll call. Now, what is the maximum primary voltage? Primary voltage, the maximum primary voltage is the maximum primary voltage is nothing but I can say that is VRMS. What is VRMS actually? VRMS value? The VRMS value is nothing but root 2 into Vn. That is the maximum primary. So maximum primary I can call, I will write as like this. Vp, Vpm. I will call us like this. Vpm is equal to root 2 into the maximum primary voltage will be 325.3 volt. Okay. Now, same the way, we need to say the maximum secondary voltage. The maximum secondary voltage we need to calculate. So, what is that? So, that is maximum secondary voltage will be we need to calculate the VDC. Now, before that, let me show here the input is 230 volt. Here, the input is 230 volt, but the output will produce 32.53. Now, you have to find a VDC voltage because as per the question, they asked to calculate first output DC voltage. That is VDC you have to calculate. VDC is equal to IDC into RL. But we don't know the value of IDC. Then what is IDC? Where IDC is equal to, already we calculated for half a rectifier, where IDC is equal to, for half a rectifier is IM by pi. Yes, this already we know, IM by pi. So IM by pi in the sense, so let me say, that is VDC is equal to, VDC is equal to, IDC IM by pi. So IM by pi into RL. So now what is VDC? The VDC is equal to This IM RL only, it's nothing but the IM RL only already we calculated, that is VSM by pi. Where VSM by is nothing but IM RL, that is VRMS, we can say. That is VRMS is equal to IM RL. That value only this much. So I can write as VDC is equal to, what is answer now? VDC? VDC answer is 10.36 volt. So this will be your output DC voltage. So now during the negative off cycle, the AC supply is diode is reverse biased. So hence it contacts but no current. So for the second, so what will happen? The maximum secondary voltage appears across the diode will be 5V is equal to, very simple. I can write the answer now. What is PIV now? PIV is equal to VM of a rectifier, right? So the VM is nothing but 32 point, because that is why, right? Output volt VM is 53 volt, 32.53, which is your output voltage. Peak inverse voltage is this much. During the negative off cycle, AC supply, the diode is reverse bias and hence conduct no current. Therefore, the maximum secondary voltage appears across the diode is 32.53, that which we calculated here. That is the thing. But your VSM, or we may call it as VM also. You can say that is also VM. So this will be the answer for this. So as of now, let us stop in this numerical. The rest of the numericals will continue in the next class.